pretty fast. It was a difficult movie to work on. It was shot in 20 days. And there was a lot of stunts. I mean, it was a pretty challenging movie. There was a lot of special effects, stunts, you know, vampires and flying flying people.
You know, with Twilight, I mean, it sounds like the movie's just made for today.
Yeah, so, yeah, so maybe that's you know, why they chose us. Honestly, maybe it had a flair of that.
So, did you get sent the script, and then you went through it and you envisioned the costume?
Yeah, I actually had two interviews. I interviewed with Jonathan Frakes, who was the director, and the producer Mark Roskin. Mark Roskin also does Leverage for TNT. It's a little plug there. And I went in for an interview. And they wanted to see more ideas, and I went back for a second interview and nailed it.
And now you're nominated. Oh, and again, I hope you win. It sounds like a wonderful project.
Thank
so
you.
how many costumes did you have to design for?
Ooh, I guess for Dawna, we probably had about 10 changes, something like that.
Right.
And I guess for Noah, we had about 7 or 10 also. You have to remember, these movies are, they're adventure movies, so, you know, they start out, the beginning of them, there's several costume changes. But then once they get into the adventure, then they don't change. You know, the clothes are the same, and there's a lot of continuity involved.
Of time passage and the things that they go through and having to keep up on all of that as well.
There's some outfits were worn more than others, in other words. You know, there's, you know, my favorite outfit that she wore in the opening sequence of the movie, her establishing costume, we would call it, was my favorite. But she's, you know, she's not even in it. I don't know, maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes into the movie, she's on to something different. So, you know, but
how did you dress the vampires?
She was a vampire, but she didn't look. I mean, she dressed in normal clothing. We had a 17th century flashback, and Vlad. That's when she is attacked and she becomes the vampire. And we had this lovely woman from Tulane Costume Department in New Orleans, Brooke Aiello. She made a vampire costume for me with like these expanding wings and stuff. She was pretty key in this movie as well, I'd like to say that, because she wasn't in the union and she couldn't really work technically on the movie. She was kind of a stitcher, but we couldn't have done it without her. She had all this experience with, you know, we had a bustier from the 17th century, and you know, I knew what to do with that a bit, but it was nice having someone around from a costume department, you know, that knew more than I did. I learned from her as well.